Hello everyone. Today in this video we are going to talk about HTTP and HTTPS. So let's start with HTTP. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. One of the most commonly used services on the internet is the World Wide Web, WWW. The application protocol that makes the web work is HTTP. HTTP is the protocol that web browsers and web servers use to communicate with each other over the internet. We can say HTTP is the foundation of the World Wide Web and is used to load web pages. For example, when you type web address in the browser like Facebook, you will notice that HTTP is added automatically in the beginning of web address, which shows that now you are using HTTP protocol to retrieve the web page. HTTP is a request and response type protocol. The client sends a request to the server, which is then processed by the server before sending a response back to the client. HTTP lacks encryption capabilities, making it less secure. Data which travels across the internet between a client and a server is not encrypted. It's in clear text. So, hackers sitting anywhere in the world could steal your information like username, password, date of birth, and credit cards. That is why secure HTTP was developed. As I told you, HTTP is a request and response type protocol. Requests include two major things, GET and POST. GET request used to retrieve the web page, while POST request used to submit the information like username and password. Response include status code and status message. Status code indicates if the request was successful or not. Status message is a short description of the status code. Let me show you these codes. First one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, and the last one. 404, this is the most frequent and most recognized error code. It means that the URL is not recognized or the resource at the location does not exist. Let me simplify HTTP with an example. In the first step, user types a URL or web address in the web browser, for example, facebook.com. In the second step, the browser first connects to a domain name server and retrieves the corresponding IP address for the web server. The browser uses a DNS resolver to map the domain to an IP address. I have already explained DNS resolver in one of my videos. There is a link in the description you can check. In third step, the web browser connects to the web server and sends HTTP request for the desired web page like facebook.com. In the fourth step, the web server receives the request and checks for the desired page. If the page exists, the web server sends it. If the server cannot find the requested page, it will send HTTP 404 error message. In the final step, the web browser receives the Facebook page from a web server and the connection gets closed. Let's talk about HTTPS. Hypertext Transfer Protocol, SCURE, is an extension of HTTP. It is used for secure communication over a computer network and is widely used on the internet. In HTTPS, the communication protocol is encrypted using transport layer security and secure socket layer. All the data which travels between a user and a server is now secured and encrypted with HTTPS protocol. It's not in clear text. It is scrambled by using encryption algorithms so hackers cannot steal your sensitive data and information. So, for example, when you open a website that requires a personal information, you would notice that an S is added to the HTTP, which means now you are using a secure protocol. Some browsers show a padlock, which indicates that secure HTTP is being used. Let's see how it works. HTTP uses an encryption protocol to encrypt communications. The protocol is called Transport Layer Security, TSL, which was previously known as Secure Socket Layer, SSL. TLS provides three main layers of protection. First one is encryption. Encrypting the data to keep it secure from hackers. It means that while the user is browsing a website, nobody can listen to their conversations, track their activities across multiple pages, or steal their information. Second one is data integrity. Data cannot be modified or corrupted during transfer, intentionally or otherwise, without being detected. Last one is authentication. It protects against man-in-the-middle attacks and builds user trust, which translates into other business benefits. This protocol secures communication by using private key and public key. Private key is controlled by the owner of a website and is used to decrypt information encrypted by the public key. While on the other hand, public key is available to everyone who wants to interact with the server in a way that is secure. Information that is encrypted by the public key can only be decrypted by private key. Alright, this was all about today's topic. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more updates. Goodbye.